In this episode, I'll use the primary and secondary color correction techniques discussed in our newly updated Final Cut Pro 10 color correction tutorial to make this uncorrected shot look like this. I'll start by placing the playhead over this uncorrected clip. Then I'll press Command 6 to automatically add the color correction effect and open the color board. Normally, I would also press Command 7 to bring up the scopes to guide my work, but for this short tutorial, I'll keep them closed. I'll start by increasing the dynamic range. So in the exposure pane, I'll bring down the shadows to about -25%, the midtones about -20%, and I'll raise the highlights about 10%. To make the shot more vibrant, I'll go to the saturation pane and increase the global saturation about 50%. To give the shot a warm fall afternoon feel, I'll go to the color pane and move the global puck into the reds. While this action warms up the background nicely, I lose the deep, cool tones of the grapes, so I'll reset that puck by pressing the delete key. I want to warm up everything except the grapes, so I'll isolate the grapes by adding a second correction, returning to the video inspector, adding a color mask to color correction 2, and sampling the grapes by clicking and dragging to add to the selection. Then I'll hold down the Command key and drag the softness slider to adjust the selection. Now, I'll go to the color board for the second correction, to the color pane, and with the outside mask button selected, I'll warm up everything except the grapes. Then I'll select inside, which allows me to correct just the grapes, and I'll use the global puck to make them a deep blue. Now my color mask has selected some of the out-of-focus grapes here, so let's exclude them from this grade by going back to the video inspector and adding a second mask to this correction, a shape mask. I'll move it over this area, make it more oval, rotate it, and adjust the feather amount. It's doing the opposite of what I want, so in the inspector, I'll drag the shape mask below the color mask and set it to subtract. Then I'll click on the mask icon to disable the on-screen controls. I can toggle both corrections off and on together by clicking the blue effects box. Click the subscribe button below. If you have an idea, comment, or suggestion, leave those below as well. Go to rippletraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.